Dr. Harding, we've done it.
And what exactly have we done?
Reverse the lysine contingency, of course.
Wait, what?
What's that?
InGen, Henry Wu, added a gene to the dinosaurs that makes them dependent on supplements of an amino acid called lysine. Without their weekly doses, they'll all die off.
You cannot give that to the dinosaurs. They need to be contained. If any of them get off the island...
Okay, listen. I've been working with the Parasaur's behavioral program for months now. If I go back to the mainland to fight for this place, they'll all be dead before I can get back, along with all of my research.
Parasaurs?
Parasaurolophus. They're herbivores, generally say.
Let me give the solution to them, to see if it even works.
How many are we talking about?
Why don't you come out with me? See how much progress we've made with them.
Henry, Dad?
Fine. We'll go.
Cool.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back playing Jurassic Park The Game. Unfortunately, humans are talking.
I'm glad to finally have you out here, Dr. Harding, despite the circumstances. We've been doing some very interesting work with our parasaurs. Behavioral communication experiments.
You've interpreted their calls?
Some of them. And I plan to use that to get them out of the pen.
Out?
Well, I'm not going to treat their water with them still in there.
But how do we know there aren't any bad dinosaurs around?
Trust me, I'm a doctor.
Trust me, sweetie. If there were any predators, we'd know. See that one? She's the lookout. She'll stand guard while the others graze. If there were any predators in the vicinity, she'd be nervous and emitting a danger call. But she's not. She's calm. Jerry, you can activate the speakers from there. Jess and I will set the various parasaur sounds that play through them.
Mr. Jerry's not convinced by this, is he?
Dad, it's okay. I mean, it's safe, right?
The parasaurs will warn us of trouble before it gets close.
Stay with Dr. Sorkin.
I feel like they resized some of the dinosaurs for this. I feel like the bigger, slightly, the triceratops felt humongous compared to the one in the film. These parasaurs are massive. But very pretty, except the bug-eyed. Little weird bug-eyed. What now?
So, what do we do?
We can't just shoo the animals out. But we should be able to manipulate them into moving using their own sounds.
Cool.
These speakers on the west side of the pen can be set to play a parasaur food call that will attract the hungry dinos. The speakers on the east control the mating sounds that will attract the more, amorous dinosaur.
What about the big set of speakers in the middle of the pen?
Ah, those emit the danger call. The parasaurs will instinctively move away from it.
So basically, we can herd the dinosaurs out of this pen using the speakers and their sounds.
Hello guys, this is gameplay mechanic, please pay attention. Right, so this is letting me sort of view the whole shebang. Got one in the middle. Okay, well if I press... Oh, I've got... I'm just going to press a button and see what happens, okay?
How do I turn on the speakers?
I'll have to tell your dad to do it when we're ready.
Oh, right, okay. Right. I'm not right now. I don't want that one on anymore. Do I not just want to put the left and right ones on? Ah. Boop. I mean, I want to pull them towards the fence, right? So surely that's the idea?
Dr. Harding?
Yeah?
I need you to activate the east side speakers, please.
Wait, that's east side.
Not
okay.
What I wanted to do. Okay. Great. Oh, I'm already feeling nervous. Not nervous, just I feel like none of it's going to work. But hey.
So, what happened to your assistant?
Let's not talk about that right now.
He's dead, goddammit.
Did you work with him long?
It doesn't matter.
Oh.
Listen, he was a wonderful young man, and I am sad. I really am. But if I let that stop my work, then all these animals will die too, trapped behind the walls that we built. You understand?
Chair is so squeaky. Right, let's try this again, shall we? What's the point in having
Dr.
these little
Harding?
Buttons?
Yeah.
If he can activate certain ones anyway.
West side speakers, please.
West side. There we go. That's what we've been looking for. Get them over to that west side. I guess we want to pull them all over to the west and then activate the spooky, spooky thing.
So I heard you were like a hippie protester or something in the 70s.
Where'd you hear that?
From Yoder.
The 70s were a tumultuous time. I fought for what I believed in. And sometimes it gets you arrested.
You were arrested? And you still got a job as a, you know, scientist?
Paleogeneticist. And yes, youth is the time to be reckless and test your boundaries. It's how you learn what's important to you.
Tumultuous is a great word. Right, I think that's like pretty much all of them on the left-hand side. Kind of accidentally, admittedly, but it has sort of worked. I think if I go for the scare tactic now, it may work. We're gonna give it a go.
If we want to move the dinosaurs forward, we might need to give them a good scare from behind.
Only way I know how.
Oh, we can use the danger call.
Good thinking.
Right, so how do I use the danger call?
Need a quick reminder about how the speakers work?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
These speakers on the west side of the pen can be set to play a parasaur food call that will attract the hungry dinos. The speakers on the east control the mating sounds that will attract the more, amorous dinosaur. The big speakers in the center emit a danger call
that will scare the dinos away from it. Be quiet. I guess Jerry's got it?
Dr. Harding?
Yeah?
Spooky
Activate
speakers.
Activate the danger speakers.
Danger zone! Am I good at video games?
That's it. They're out.
Good job, Jess.
That was...
Finally! Go forth and multiply.
Confusing.
You're pretty good at this. Maybe you'll be a behavioral scientist someday.
Maybe I will.
No, whatever. Good stuff. Parasols look like elderly women.
Ah, this is why she was elected to be the lookout. What's wrong with her foot?
It's a broken toe. Feel free to have a look. I just have to do one more thing, and then we can leave.
The lysine.
If the dinosaurs are to have a fighting chance, they'll need the solution to survive.
I'm still not sure.
Jerry, this is my life's work. These are basically my children. I'm not gonna let these creatures die because some bureaucrat can't stand losing control. They deserve their own lives.
Jess.
Oh, Jerry, I feel you.
Dr. Sorkin?
Laura.
Laura, what's lysine?
InGen, Henry Wu, added a gene to the dinosaurs that makes them dependent on supplements of an amino acid called lysine. Without their weekly doses, they'll all die off.
Don't tell my dad, but I got a D in chemistry.
Then today should be very educational. The solution we were creating at the lab will reverse this scenario, allowing the animals to live out their natural lifespan. We just need to get it into the main water supply.
Okay, that should be easy, right?
This is a big responsibility, Jess.
I can handle it, Dr. Sorkin. I mean, Laura.
Police. Okay, Jess, let's get started.
Dr. Sorkin, I'm trying to talk.
I'm telling you, man, almost made me swear off Chinese food forever.
Yeah, right. I've never seen you refuse an egg roll. Ever.
I said almost. Besides, my date was hot. You remember? The girl with the blonde hair, red scarf, what was her name?
I don't keep track.
Oh, you remember her. She was the one that was wearing the... Hold on. You hear that?
A helicopter. Someone's stealing the chopper.
Go, go, go!
Oscar, you utter madman. You weigh like 500 pounds.
Okay, you win. Set the chopper down.
No!
You're putting Oscar's life in danger. He doesn't really like that. Oscar, get over here. I'll pull you in.
There we go. Good stuff.
Come on, man. That's it.
This is dangerous stuff, lads. Dangerous stuff. We're sticking on YouTube.
One more.
Tell She's dead when I get in there.
Come on, Oscar. Put those giant friggin' arms to work. Get in here.
We can do this, boys. We can do this. Do I want to? I don't really like Oscar, so I'm not that sad if he falls to his doom, admittedly. Bloody Nora, this requires some button pressing, doesn't it? Jeez Louise! There we go.
You're one stubborn son of a... Hey! What the hell?
No problem. You got this.
Stop this thing! Now!
Not gonna happen.
Whose side am I meant to be on here? Both of them are idiots. Oh!
We good?
No. Not so good.
Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs.
Is the water ready? Yep, lysine is now officially a part of this nutritionally balanced dino breakfast.
Excellent. Now I just need to get this water into the main supply and we'll be done.
I want to talk about the lysine
That's
contingency.
It, Jess. We did it.
Stop talking.
Jess, come up here. I want you to see this.
Is this when
this
it all goes to hell?
Is how nature intended these animals to exist.
Wow. With all the running away I've been doing, I haven't had time to really appreciate them.
Oh, girl, take it easy.
What's wrong with that one?
Oh, no.
Raptors!
Raptors.
Dad!
Jerry, run!
Yo, Jerry, pay attention, lad. Oh! It's so cold, my hands are seizing up. It's making it very difficult to do this. Okay, I'm ready though. My right hand barely works, but it's fine! Whoa! Jesus, lemony gypsies. The raptors are pretty baller. Oh, hello, love. Run, Jerry, run! I tried to scratch my nose for a second, it was a terrible idea. Right, I went right, not left. Was that a bad idea? Oh, it's fine. Climb, 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 climb.
Oh my god, Dad, that was awesome!
Guess the old man still has a few good moves, huh?
You are lucky to be alive, Jerry. I've never seen anyone outrun a velociraptor before.
I'm not lucky, I'm a gut up hero. From?
What are they doing out here?
Must have escaped from the quarantine pen somehow.
Raptors are highly intelligent. They'll find a way up here if we give them enough time.
Yes! It's Yoder!
Here! We're down here!
There! Down here!
It's not stopping! No. Going, hold on!
Thanks for that, Yoda, you tool. Oh, God. Is that the end of the chapter? Maybe? Oh, it is! Right, lysine contingency, really quickly. Lysine contingency doesn't work. It, like, literally doesn't function as planned in the slightest. They cover that in the film. They say, you know, the dinosaurs just eat the plants and it's got enough lysines in them to keep them alive. It is, like, the worst failsafe in the world.
Here.
Anyway, I'm done now.
Down here. Down here!
And the carnivores eat the herbivores. And that's how they get their lysine.
No. Dad!
Going,
hold on.
No!
It's okay. I think we're okay.
Oh my god, those poor people.
That's fine.
How you holding up, honey?
I want to go home.
I know, sweetheart. Me too. We'll be fine. I promise.
Dad, the raptors! Look!
God, they're trying to bring the tower down.
It'll hold. It's got to.
Yeah, well, I don't want to take any chances.
Mm-hmm.
We need to get off the tower before the raptors bring it down.
The emergency ladder's right there. The way the tower is tilting, it will put us down outside the paddock.
Well, that's a start, but the fence isn't much of an obstacle for the raptors. Where do we go once we're out?
I think we can make it to the utility tunnels, right over there. We can lock the raptors out if we can beat them inside.
I hope you're right. Let's get that ladder lowered.
And that's where all the troodons are, right? If I remember correctly. I'm kind of curious what the journal is. We're going to take a look at that at the end. I don't think I've ever had a look.
That should free it up. Won't budge.
All right, Harding.
It's brand new, so it might still be a little stiff. Maybe if you put more weight on it?
What, you mean stand on it?
Yes, ride it down.
Okay, but we should probably be ready to move as soon as it comes down so we can stick together.
Let's go!
Sweetheart, listen. I want you to be ready to climb down the ladder as soon as it's extended.
Okay, Dad.
Dr. Sorkin!
I'll be right down.
It's really stuck. Oh, no, I see the problem. The whole ladder is just slightly bent. It can't slide freely. We might be able to force it.
Must have been the crash.
Looks that way. I think we're gonna need a crowbar or something to get it open.
Oh, well then we're gonna have to get creative because there are no tools up here.
Creative is my middle name. Jerry Creative Harding, that's what they call me. Well, it must be over here, right? I'm not dinner. Stop looking at me like I'm dinner. This tool right there.
This antenna could be just the thing we need to pry the ladder open. But if I try to grab it now, I could get electrocuted.
Okay. Turn the power off. That's what we're looking for.
Dr. Sorkin, that antenna is the only thing up here I've seen that we can use to pry the ladder open. Is there any way to turn the power to those lights off so I can grab it?
Not from up here. The aircraft alert beacons aren't ever supposed to be disabled. The best I can do is make them flash on and off.
How?
I can switch them from nighttime to daytime operation. They shine continuously at night, but during the day they flash to provide more contrast.
There's just such an unnecessary amount of exposition in this game. Like, you wouldn't say any of that, would you? You just go, they just flash in the daytime, just believe me, get over it.
Okay, I've switched the beacon lights to daytime mode. Hopefully that wire won't be live while the lights flash off.
Otherwise you're dead, son. Right, okay, we're ready. There we look at that.
Got it.
Like I've been stealing antennas my whole life.
If I couldn't move it by jumping on it, I'm never going to be able to pry it by myself. Dr. Sorkin?
Yes?
Can you give me a hand with this? You pry while I put my weight on the ladder.
Certainly.
Okay, Dr. Sorkin, I'm ready. Jess, honey, you get ready to move as soon as the ladder goes down.
I'm ready, Dad. Just hurry!
Okay, Dr. Sorkin, on three. Ready? One, two, three!
Oh my god.
You've gotta be freaking kidding me!
Dad, what are we gonna do?
Try again!
Get
on
eaten
three.
Alive,
ready?
Maybe.
One, two, three! No, Jess, wait! No!
She's a mad woman!
I'm fine, Dad!
Your turn, Dr. Sorkin.
Right, I'm coming down.
Dr. Sorkin, you have to hurry!
Out of the way! I'm gonna jump for it!
Like bloody Lara Croft,
okay,
she is.
Now up and over!
Right, I'm controlling Sorkin, but it looks
I'm
good.
I'm okay.
Not for long.
Run, Dr. Sorkin!
Yes, you say he can distract them, okay? Sorkin, what are you doing? Stop looking at the raptors!
Come on, they're right behind you!
Pump those crazy legs! Just keep running, this is how we run.
Dr. Harding, the door.
The door.
Too late. Run.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. I wasn't ready. Oh, my hands are so cold. We all just got brutally slaughtered, but I really wanted to just play the game and just die at every available opportunity. That's more like it. Tell you what, promoting you a medal for one mess up, it's a harsh little game, this. Oh, God.
Next time I get a headache like this, there better be tequila involved.
No way, amigo. This turned out better than the last time you drank tequila.
Squeak. Squeak, squeak.
Yeah, you might be right. The girl I woke up next to is prettier anyway.
What is the plan, Oscar, my man?
So, we lost our ride, and the only person we managed to rescue so far doesn't even work for InGen. Now what?
See if you can find anything useful in the wreck. And make sure the girl's okay while I scout the perimeter.
God damn it, I left my AK inside the chopper. It's probably toast. Glad I didn't leave a round chambered. Could have killed someone.
That makes two of us, amigo. Still, the cook-off was a hell of a show.
Wonder if we ever find Decaf.
Damn it, all our weapons were in there. I was just getting used to that AK, too.
AK-47, not
an
AK-2.
Better keep checking her out. If she's gonna blow, we don't want to be anywhere nearby.
Huh? Get it? It's a joke. Huh?
Gonna take more than an auxiliary power unit to fix her this time. Looking pretty safe. One more look, just to be sure. No fuel left. Must have been a hell of a blast. That chopper's done all the exploding she's ever gonna do. Should be safe to make camp here.
Okay, step one completed. Step two.
I should see if the girl's okay.
Why do I have one knee pad on? I mean, I approve. One knee pad is the right number of knee pads, in case you're curious.
Oscar might want to talk to her when she wakes up. Let's postpone that little reunion.
Anything else? We got some weird little wibbly wobbly plants. I can go really far to the left for no apparent reason. Ooh, hello. What have we? Ah! The embryos must be ruined by now, surely.
Wow, Barbasol. I have a can just like this back in San Jose. Oh man. I hope it's not for her face. Heavier than I remember. Could just be full, I guess. It's only sloshing at the top. Sounds half empty, feels full. Why is that? My stepbrother used to store his second set of keys in a fake pop can. I wonder.
I really want a fake one. You can get like...
A lady has a secret stash. What the hell is it?
You can get like amazing replica ones. I really am gonna have to get one at some point. And then pretend that I'm Dennis Nedry and just get myself murdered. The dream!
T-Rex, it's leaving.
Damn it, Oscar. I only have one pair of pants. The chopper's not gonna blow, but just about everything in it, including our weapons, is flame broiled.
No game trails, no nests. This is base camp for now.
Hey, get this. I found this can of shaving cream in her pack.
Didn't think you needed any.
Yeah, whatever you say, Fuzzy. Except it's not really shaving cream. Look. So, now what's the plan? We're gonna try to salvage this gig?
Yeah. I'm gonna go look for our friends.
Shouldn't I come with?
We lost the guns. Means I gotta be in stealth mode.
You saying I can't sneak?
I'm saying neither one of us can sneak and watch her at the same time. Besides, she won't talk with me around. But maybe pretty boy Billy can get her to open up.
Yeah, it's a tough job.
I don't really see you as a sneaker either, Oscar. Not gonna lie.
Dios mío, they open doors.
Here we go. A gold thing is flashing. That means I have to do things. Means I have to warm up my hands in preparation.
Should have stayed in bed.
Okay, I'm ready. Hoorah. We're gonna do finger exercises. Oh yeah, I'm a ninja. Qua. Oh, the poor parasaur. Okay, must be something else to do, right? Oh, no. You are a hungry son of a gun, right? Let's go down and round. There we go. So who is the last one you pick? What? Seriously? What? You didn't, nothing happened! You just walked. Oh, I hate that. This is actually ridiculous. You have to be so quick. Oh, boy.
We should get moving.
Locked. Smart.
Surely you have to be a genius to figure out how to lock a door when there's raptors trying to eat your face. I never would have come up with that personally.
Dios mío, how am I not dead? They left me alone. Idiotas.
Where is Yoda?
Pull me out of there. Not sure I'd do the same. Looks like I was only out for a little while. The embryos should be okay for now.
But they are no longer your embryos.
Where's the cane? Nieta, no!
Looking for this?
That's mine!
You know, this takes me back. I learned to shave with this stuff.
Give it back! Now!
I'm all out of shaving cream myself. You mind if I borrow some?
Stop shaking it!
But you're supposed to shake it before you use it. Says so right on the can. You want to tell me what's so important about shaving cream? Or do I ask InGen?
Embryos! Dinosaur embryos. If you drop them, they'll be destroyed.
Embryos, huh? Wow. I knew you were up to something, but this is pretty clever, I gotta admit. InGen's gonna love me for bringing this back. Talk about a bonus.
Look, Yoder. Billy, right? Maybe we can make a deal.
This ought to be good. Shoot.
Money!
There's a lot of money in it for you if I get those embryos to my contact before they go bad. Those embryos are worth over $1 million. That's US dollars. I have a buyer.
I just need you to take us there, and we'll both be rich.
Oh, yeah, right. Like, InGen isn't gonna shine a light on an independent contractor like me when they figure out the crown jewels are missing. No sale.
How much does InGen pay you to risk your life? How long before they replace you after you lose a leg or break your back and can no longer jump out of helicopters for them?
Don't you worry about it. I get paid plenty to do what I do.
It's always the last one I click.
You turn that over to InGen. You get a pat on the back, maybe a little Christmas bonus. You leave it to me, you become a rich man. Pay off your debts, quit your job. No more guys in suits telling you what to do. Just think about it.
Okay. Keep talking.
Please. I don't expect you to trust me, but the right thing to do is to give it back to me and let me go.
Must I reveal my daughter? I must reveal my daughter.
I have a daughter. I need the money to get her out of the ghetto. You know what happens to girls there. She doesn't deserve that life.
Are you for real?
Come on, Billy. The money's good. And you'll be helping me save my daughter. Everybody gets a little something.
Okay, here's the deal. One, I'm in charge. I keep the embryos. And as soon as it's safe to break away, we'll deliver them to your contact.
I don't know if the embryos will last in there much longer.
That's a risk we're gonna take. Two, we're cutting Oscar in.
Why?
Because he's my partner, that's why. It'll be fine. Trust me. Now, sit tight and lighten up. Not every woman gets to enjoy the sunset on a tropical island with Billy Yoder.
I'm not sure she's loving the idea, Billy. No harm, lad. Come on, safe point. Oh yeah, oh yeah, look at that little spinning little son of a gun. Right, episode 3, ladies and gentlemen, The Depths. I'm trying to remember what happens. It does kind of come back to me a little bit. I thought it was a 5-episode game, which is why I was a little bit more confused as to what actually happens. But it is only a 4-episode game, unlike later Telltale stuff, which actually became 6-episode games at some point, right? Okay, we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, as per usual. I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, please consider smashing that like button down below. It really helps me out. And also hitting the subscribe button if you want to be kept up to date with brand new videos about dinosaurs, animals, aliens, and everything else we do here on the BestInSlot channel. All of you who have subscribed so far, that's awesome. Make sure you hit that little bell icon. I'll highlight now. Otherwise, you may actually miss out on the content anyway because YouTube is silly. Thank you guys so much. Much love.